Where'd that pen go? Alright, just grab a new one, I guess. Feels good. Dialab, what's good, homie? Back in the BBQ. So Webb's there too. Webb's, what's good? GT Chong, what's good? Everybody's here, huh? Everybody back at the barbecue. How's everybody doing, y'all? Outcast in the building too. Man, that's crazy. All the usual suspects back in the building. You guys good with this view? I'm trying to figure out a way to hold this guy up and show you guys what I'm working on. And it's getting very, very technical now. I'm trying to get into little cracks in between Mike's biceps and trying to separate the whites and blacks and just develop the whole print. Like, for example, here I just found like a little white rod. I don't know what the heck it is, but I know it's white. So we're just gonna paint that in so that way we can start figuring out the whole background. It's almost like doing a puzzle, man. Really, it really is when it boils down to it. Complicated puzzle at that. It's like we're working in reverse. So you gotta expect it to take a little bit of time. I'm sure there's easier ways to do this. 100%. Just kind of like doing it this way. I don't know why. Preference, I guess. It's crazy as I'm drawing everybody out. You're just looking at everybody's snapshot moment of their what their face looked like when they saw this shot go up. And that's pretty historical. Literally aiming for exactly where this backboard's at. Every little point here. Try to get as close as possible to where it is on the picture. So intricate. I can see the steps. I'm sitting here painting in individual steps. This looks like a little stencil piece. It is. A little culprit. How'd you try to stay on? I'll show you where I'm at, guys. Man, we got a long way to go. We got Russell kind of 75% there, I'd say. Started to draw that center in. This guy, I don't know what this dude was looking at when Jordan is shooting the shot here with like the last second to go, but he was definitely out of the play. Everybody was out of this play, really. So we got quite a bit to go, but my goal today is at least to get a little bit more of the background inked in, and then also to start painting in faces as well. So that's kind of the next phase that I'm at today. Yesterday I had a real short session, so I'm hoping maybe I can go about an hour and a half today and get as much as I can completed on this one shoe. Again, I'm not working on the other side yet because I'm trying to knock one out. I feel like if I could knock this side out, I have a sense of completion and some progress there. And so then getting to the other one, which will be a lot easier because it's not like Jordan and all the details here, probably going to be more focused on. So hopefully you guys think I'm doing okay. This is day three, but technically not day three. I mean, I barely worked yesterday. So yeah, let's get down. Let's get down to work. Before I do, just want to shout out all the Patreon members, man. You made it on time to class, man. You guys jumped in immediately when I went live. So thanks for jumping on. So a special shout out real quick, the homie Webb's Custom Kicks, Patreon family, the Die Lab, also Patreon family, GT Chong, also Patreon family, Outcast, also Patreon family, everybody in the Patreon family, thank you guys again for supporting. I think you guys kind of have an idea if you looked at the Patreon channel yesterday who this pair is for. It's kind of a sneak peek at, you know, the next Flip My Kicks episode, and I think that this person's gonna be super happy with this when it's done, hopefully. Knock on wood, but you know, again, we're painting Michael Jordan, so this can't be messed up. There's no messing up Jordan, that's for dang sure. So with that said, just thanks for again, guys, just watching and seeing what I've been up to on this. We got people saying what's up to each other. Everybody knows each other now, huh? That's awesome. And then Outcast, you got a progress pig jumping in the Discord. Speed Infusion, if you're there, Speed Infusion is the admin here. He'll send you guys a link to the Discord if he's got a chance to. And is that the last shot or Elo? No, this is the last shot. Elo was the other one I was thinking about doing with him pumping his fist in the air, like jumping right after he hit the shot. I'm sure you know which what spot I'm talking about in that moment, right after he hit the shot and he's in the air. He was super, I mean, understandably super amped to hit that shot as well. Again, an awesome SHOT Show. Let me jump over real quick. I always forget to do this in the beginning. Guys, today we are streaming on Facebook, we're streaming on Twitch, and we're streaming on YouTube as well. So just want to say a quick shout out to the other folks over here. Mr. Madlock, I didn't work for Angelus. I actually did contractual work for them to do tutorials for them. Shout out for you for jumping on the channel, bro. Who else we got over here? I know I said what's up to all these Twitch. Everybody's on Twitch. Okay, cool. I think mainly everybody's on Twitch today. That's crazy. Sick. So I'm on multi-stream now, guys. If you haven't had a chance to say what's up, because I'm going to jump on the... Is this the last shot? I guess we have determined this is called the last shot. I don't want to say the wrong thing. I sound dumb. But if it is, it is. But you guys know what I'm... But hopefully I'm painting at this point. Today I'm going to just kind of work on the crowd, work on the background, get things kind of put in place face-wise. And once I can get that done, we can start to put on a little bit of paint as well. So let me see what I just did. I did a bonehead move, and I think I deleted the picture. I did. Where's that delete? Of course, it deletes right there. So I got to be careful for that. And I'm going to try to angle this guy right here. Is that good for you guys? Can you guys see that okay? Let me know. I'm going to start working on the left side just because of the angle of my computer here. I could see the left side a little bit better. If you guys have questions, please feel free to shout them out. I'm just trying to at least get a little bit of progress done here though. So if I can, I'm gonna knock a little bit of this out and then we'll talk. But I'm sure if you guys have any questions, a lot of the Patreon guys that are in this channel will be more than happy to help out as well. The seasoned vets. Y'all really are seasoned vets, man. Some of you guys are so knowledgeable with your what you know and what you've experimented with. So many different things you can do to customize, right? This guy's him. So luckily for me, I did identify a couple of people, and you guys could see, like, for example, this guy in the gray here. I got his face enough where I can trace it out a little bit, and it gives me an opportunity to know, like, okay, cool, I'm pretty dead on with where people need to be. This guy could probably be moved a little bit over here though, so I think I do need to move him. But when it comes to kind of retracing a whole scenario like this, you need to have places where you can depend on that you know that the marks are for sure. So again, like this guy up here, I know who he is in the crowd because I've already spotted him, and I'm looking at Mike's wristband, and then I'll look to the left of his wristband and I say, oh, okay, it's this dude. Dude's got kind of a longer neck. And so I can start to piece them together. I'll tell you, this is not easy to do. For a lot of people, it's kind of difficult to visualize placement, but this is a good way to start practicing. Some people don't start off like this. They'll start off by putting paint down. And that's okay too. That's just really a preference, I guess. not trying to shade everything in, but at least get some of the darker parts to be a little bit darker. So when I start to lay down paint, should be a little bit easier to cover up. Let me check the comments real quick. That's good. Okay, cool. Just making sure I didn't miss anything. What pens is that you are using? I forgot the name. I know you don't. Oh, Webs. I knew I missed a comment. This is the Micron, Pigma Micron. This is a 01. I think that they do have one that's a slightly smaller tip. This is this one says 0.25 millimeters. And I think I have another one here. Let's see if. Yeah, this one, let's see what it says. No, this is the same pen. I just got a different top on it. But I know there's a different, smaller tip as well. But yeah, I use this a lot for just, you know, the usual laying down things, or if I need to line things out. Instead of using a paintbrush, if you need something real thin, you can jump into a Micron. And it gives a lot of nice, clean detail. A lot of people use these for comic book drawing and inking in. So if you're wondering, this is kind of like an artist pen, and it's used kind of general use. Like there's not like one real use for it. It could be used for multiple projects, so that's why I like this. Right, I'm gonna jump on the right side now. Sometimes I'll bounce back and forth. Just depends on what mood I'm in, where I'm flowing. Takes time, so if I feel like I'm not getting somewhere with the picture, sometimes I'll go to another spot that might be a little bit easier to draw. You know, wait off on the more complicated parts. Either way, it's gotta get done, but funny, somebody here has a lady has a sign that says nice kicks. Crazy. What are the chances? Definitely got to include her in here. So I'm trying to locate everybody else in here, and man, it's just like a jumble of different things going on. Some of them I can't tell if it's like camera equipment, so I'm just gonna try my best to get that same shape down. Anything that I've kind of seen that area. The good part about that is, if I can't notice it, then no one's gonna be looking at it that much when the shoes are done. Eventually I gotta start putting some pen down and adding some grays, so let me jump into some grays. Got a ton of grays. This can be a good and a bad thing. Sometimes I'll just mix them too, because really all you gotta do is either add white or add black. Lighten it or darken it up. Alright, so I'm gonna put this guy down real quick. We've got a little tray here we'll peel off. It is the last shot, I believe. GT Chung. Dalab, what you working on, bro? You can't just say I'm working on a little something and then not say nothing. Is the stream freezing, guys? Let me know. I think we just had a small issue. I just saw the click to read your unread notifications. Oh, snap. Oh, yeah, that sucks, man. I'm sorry, guys. Has it been dropping on you guys? Let me know if it's been dropping, because I see there's been a couple of notifications saying that maybe the stream has been freezing up a little bit. Are you guys there? Let me know, please. While you guys are saying yes or no, if I'm there, I'm not. I got to keep going anyway, so I'm going to jump into dropping some grays down real quick. First guy I'm going to use is Mist. Mist is awesome. It's like off gray. It's just like a white and a gray combined. And I don't like to waste too much paint, so I'll just drop a little bit in there. Especially when I don't know exactly what I'm going to do with it yet. So we've got a gray and a dark gray here too. Just kind of put them in order. Alright, so that's the darker one. Then I've got gray. So I'll put gray over here. And I know I've got one more gray, so let me just search for that. It should be a light gray. If I don't find it, I think I got white cement, so that might make do. At least it's a different kind of scale gray. Really what we're trying to achieve here is getting different shades. So yeah, guys, I think I might be SOL on that. Oh, let's see, I got a light gray here. Let's see if this comes through. Sick, I think that's my go. Cool. Well, that's nice. I got some color selection for once. Usually I'd miss something. We'd have to mix it. So that's a unclean brush. Don't show that on camera. Let's clean this guy off a little bit. Must have forgot yesterday. Usually I don't forget that. Shame on me. I'm just trying to break this little paint up a little bit on the front of it. There we go. Want to keep it nice and sharp there. Let's see what else we got here. This guy looks good to start with. All right, guys. I'm gonna start with this here. Is a Princeton 20-0 round petite. It's pretty petite. It's probably how it got its name. Looking for just anybody who I could start to paint in face-wise. There's a lot of lighter skin folks in the crowd here, so I guess it doesn't really matter where I start. NBA logo's white too. So I gotta really dig in. Be careful of how I do this. The way I look at it, I'm gonna probably have to clean up around it anyways. So it's probably best that if I'm gonna go thinner or thicker, I'm gonna go a little bit thicker. Alternative would be to grab a thinner brush. Why not? Let's do that. Smaller space, work with a smaller brush. That only makes sense, right? Trying to get that outline of the NBA logo is even not easy. There we go. That's when you get to that like super fine detail work. This kind of stuff could take hours. Really just depends on how skilled you are with the brush and how fast you could paint and how detailed you want to go with it. Let's get start to detail out Jordan a little bit now. Put this guy down real quick, guys. Let me show you where I'm at because I need to get that white. Got a lot of fixing of Jordan's jersey still. I don't really concentrate on Jordan until like the end though. I want to make sure like when we finalize everything, he's the last and most freshest piece when we're all done. So if you guys see that he's a little blurry at some spots or there's errors, it's because there's a lot of refining that's left to do. And that I'll just, you know, I usually have to do some of that off camera as well. So first thing that's bothering me, we're gonna get rid of it, is this O. It's like getting surgical with it right here. You get good with the brush. I loaded too much white right there. And it's okay if I overload on the brush, I can always go back in and fix it, so if that happens to you, don't be frustrated. feel like a big part of this is how much pressure you put on this brush. And then once you get the pressure down, how well can you bead that brush? Meaning like how straight of a line can you get the brush going consistently? I've seen some artists drag out a line super long and you're just like, how are they even doing that? Chad can't color. Dude just drags a whole line down surfboard with no problem. Look how you dip the paint once with the brush. Some people know how to do it. They're experts at that, you know? Sure, there's a lot of other ones. Clean that brush off as I go along. Let's jump back on that other brush now. We got a lot of graying to do. So again, looking for light gray spots. Important that try to bang out as much as I can, at least with that first color here. Remember this dude over here, he had a jumpsuit on. Here he goes, okay. It's crazy to see how people are all dressed in the game behind the game and how much fashion was involved back then too. Now I could paint in all the gray spots here. Before they were just markers for me. Now I could see who they are. The faces should be around here. Start lightening them up a little bit. Let me lower this volume before I get flagged, yo. Alright. Give me a second, y'all. Oh man, is that Antoine Carr? I think that's who it was. Ostertag sucks. I haven't heard that name for a long time. Greg Ostertag, man. That's funny what big men we had in the league, huh? They're all just trying to stop all these crazy guards. And it was difficult to do. Even the Bulls had three, like, mediocre centers. Nobody was excellent. Webs, I think I said it before. What pen is that? I know. if you're talking about this pen, it is a Micron, Pigma Micron 01, 0.25 millimeters. Yeah. So speaking of, I think you're right. That was Antoine Carr. This dude right here. Just because you said that, I'm gonna jump back on Antoine. Man, these names are old school right here. What does this look like? I need to pull him down a little bit. Anybody have a guess how long it's going to take me to just finish this shoe? A guesstimate, how long you think it'll take? I'd love to hear what you guys think. Then I'll compare it at the end and see what the actual answer was. Peak after peak after mountain peak here. And then it stops right where this Bulls logo is. Cool. I like that. When you start to draw something out and then it ends at a spot that you could see was pretty accurate. So that was a good sign. Peak after peak. Drawing all these little mountains on his jersey. It's not easy. It gets jagged at the end. Now we still gotta shadow out the mountains. So what do we got here? We got this one like this. I feel like if I had just taken some more time and worked on the stencil, then I could have just made this a stencil, and perhaps this would have came out already completed and finished, but it's okay. We can still manage. And I think a lot of the times people don't have a stencil cutter anyway, so you could see now just the process and how long it does take. Man, I never thought I'd be drawing a Jazz jersey this small in my life. Literally drawing Z after Z here. Oh man, that's really small. Cool, I got it done though. Alright, let's try. Start to draw Antoine in a little bit. Where's the other paint at? Alright, so let's go. A little bit of darker areas here by his armpit. I'm just gonna start there. Lighter on the end. So I just do like a light gray. Fill in the other side. I'm gonna be going down the arm just to keep with the flow. He's got light on his shoulder blade a little bit. And this is where, like, some people, what they like to do is blend the two colors in. If you wanna do that, then you just kinda clean off any excess paint. You want there to be just enough paint between the two here. You can draw in there kind of the shape where his armpits are at, you know, stuff, little detail stuff you can.